the LSAT passages are on totally random topics that you're not likely to be familiar with. I would imagine that on any given passage, 1% or fewer of the test takers even have read anything on that topic before. So it's totally new. And that being new is something you'll come across in things like The Economist and Scientific American, where they're really, I mean, they're general, but they're also certainly not pre-law materials, right? So I imagine that most people studying for the LSAT don't have a Scientific American subscription, and not that many of them have subscriptions to The Economist, although it's more popular among pre-laws. That's still a publication that you don't have an immediate need for, and it's a little bit complex. You know, it's not like it's on a sixth grade reading level. It's meant for people who have already graduated from college and maybe even have graduate level degrees, so who have a general interest in world policy and affairs. But it's topics, they're going in depth. Like, here's what's happening within China. Here's what's happening within India. It's things that we're probably not looking at too closely on a daily basis. Then the other thing is that it's worded, those are, especially The Economist, is worded in a somewhat scholarly way. So, and scholars, academics, you know, you've read things in college, right? These are things that they're not beach reading. They're meant to be complex. They're trying to impress you with how smart they are. They're taking a while to get to the point. And reading comp is like that, but even more so. So people read those publications because they're probably more interesting than the LSAT. People do read The Economist and Scientific American for fun, but the passages are written for the LSAT specifically. Nobody reads that for fun. So if you're on your commute somewhere, like let's say you were taking the train or the bus, like you could read it on the commute. During the pandemic, that might not be the case for most people, in which case, if that's what you want to read just, you know, before, as you wind down for bed, you could do that. But with nearly 400 passages, I don't see a need to go beyond the passages themselves if you want to just be getting ready to do passages. Thanks for tuning into the show. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already to be notified of new episodes as I release them. And feel free to reach out if you need anything at all as you move forward with your prep. I'm happy to help however I can. In the meantime, I wish you all the best and take care.